to the editor re after exam, president is found to be of sound mind and body, front page, January 17. It is worth noting that while a cognitive test such as the Montreal cognitive assessment that was used to test President Trump can detect signs of dementia, it in no way rules out most other mental illnesses, including major ones and especially personality disorders that some have speculated the president may suffer from. I do not know whether Mr. Trump suffers from a mental disorder, but to imply that a normal score on a cognitive exam in any way rules this out would be like saying that if someone had a normal cardiac exam that would rule out the possibility of diabetes. Stephen A. King, PhilDELPHIA. The writer is a physician. To the editor, despite Dr. Ronnie Jackson's assessment of President Trump's health, questions remain. Most people shrink as they age, but amazingly, as noted in the Times article, this president gets taller. Dr. Jackson claims that our president, who is just shy of obese, sleeps only 3 or 4 hours a night, loves junk food and doesn't exercise, is in excellent health. Slightly less exuberance would be more believable. Patricia Weller Emmitsburg, MD. To the editor, according to Dr. Ronnie Jackson, an overweight 71-year-old man with evidence of coronary artery disease who does no exercise and feasts mainly on fast food is in excellent health. Surely it is time for a ghost writer to write President Trump's next book, The Trump Diet and Lifestyle, Your Guide to Excellent Health. Brian Gorman, Rochester, Min. To the editor, President Trump's diagnosis needs a second opinion. Malcolm McDonald, Melbourne, Australia.